catch them in the pasture, run them in the pen, work them on the Sundays, do it all again. Race them in the sand, buck them in the mud, drip a cowboy's sweat, bleed a cowboy's blood.
All right, here we are. I don't know what happened. You guys are tuned in once again to another Pepper Stewart show with everybody under the weather, or in the weather, under the weather, however you want to say it. Because obviously those cold fronts coming in, making it 80 degrees, or the allergies.
Everybody need to get a macchiato, honey whiskey.
The massage of honey whiskey, what are you talking about?
Honey whiskey. Macchiato honey whiskey.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Get over that cold, getting it.
Yeah, let's do that. Let's do that. Let's throw it over here and see what's going on the other side. If you look around, as we rotate over, we got the guys in here today from the Buck and Hunger event, which could be October 15th. So we start over here. We got Glen Cooper over here on that side. In the middle, you got world champion bullfighter Jesse Vick. And then you got some guy sitting on the other side. I don't know who that is.
I'm in the corner, like I've been in the corner all my life.
That's in the corner or in the closet?
Well, that too. Oh. Both. All
right. We got it figured out.
Whatever.
Yeah. We got stuff today. We're going to tell you about the Buck and Hunger event that's coming up October 15th. And see what's going on with that deal. They're going to have the bullfights. You're going to have the concert. The Pony Bronx. Mutton busting. Vendors. And I hear they're going to have a bull riding too. Big bull rider. So with that... Glen, you want to tell us about that? A little bit more about that?
Yeah, Pepper, me and Andy Dowley, we started this thing back in 2012, just sitting in an office trying to figure out what we could do as far as trying to have a fundraiser for the food bank there in Johnson County. We started it in 2012. This is our fifth year, and it just gets bigger and bigger. We're very fortunate with the caliber of people that we have coming out as far as our stock contractors. We have Jimmy Fricks, in cahoots with Chris Knapp, so the bulls that are coming are always some top quality bulls. We added the bullfights 3 years ago, and Jesse was our champion at the first one. He was the champion last year. He was interrupted by Ryan Pfizer in the middle, so that's always been a good battle to watch. We also, last year, we added the pony bareback riding. That was quite a hit with the crowd. We have six kids coming, and these kids are serious. These kids, just about all of them have qualified for the NFR in Vegas that happens in December. But this, like I said, we started this thing in 2012. It just gets bigger and bigger. 100% of the proceeds go to the Open Door Food Bank. We don't take a dime. And that Open Door Food Bank, that thing is just amazing. I've been out there and helped them work it. And they will have... No joke, they'll have anywhere from 1,300 to 1,500 people show up every Saturday. It's a bi-monthly deal. Like I was looking the last one they had, which was 2 weeks ago, and they gave away 115,000 pounds of food. So that's why we do this, to help out the community, and we try to put on a good show as well.
And it's a good show. We were out there last year, come out last year to check out the festivities. So it's a good show, and it serves a good cause, and you get to watch some good rodeo action out there. There's a lot of stuff going on. We got stuff today, guys. We're going to talk about some alligators eating cows. We've got cattle prices. William Shatner. What's William Shatner doing? The Prime Minister of Nova Scotia got caught catching something. So we'll tell you about that. In Canada, Taco Bell is going to give you something special. You get something special already when you go to Taco Bell, but they're going to add something a little more special to that deal. And if you over in the UK and your record player stops working, just get a new banknote and it'll play record. Well, so that's what we got. We got a lot of stuff coming up.
You also got somebody wanting to give me some money too. Can we talk about that?
Yeah, yeah. Tex informed me today that he's probably no longer be with the show because he's become a millionaire. He got an email today that confirms that, so we're going to find out about that.
And I may be moving to another country.
Which country are you moving to?
Somebody.
Where are you going?
Ukraine.
To the Ukraine?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. You got rich. You're going to be rich. Then you're going to the Ukraine.
I may find a mail order bride.
A mail order bride or a... What?
What? Oh. That's not how it works. You go over there and then order one from the U.S.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm still long in this deal. I don't know.
You sure it's a mail order bride or a female order bride? I don't know.
I hope it's a female.
That's even worse. Oh,
Melina, I'm just kidding. You can do my shout out.
Oh, yeah.
I gotta give my shout out. Yeah.
Always shout out. Always shouting out stuff. But we got the man here. We got the world champion Jesse Vick here. Talk about some stuff. So, what do you got going on, Jesse? What have you been up to? What's been keeping you busy?
Just staying busy, fighting bulls and staying in front of some. Dealt with some few injuries this year and worked right through it. Stayed in the arena and. nothing keeps me out, so it's a love for this sport, and it's a sport that most people don't know about, and it's a but when you do know about it as a fighter like yourself, heard you stepped around a few in your day
in the old days
it takes a special kind of person to get hit, get broken bones and stuff like that, and overcome those injuries and get back in the arena without anything fighting ahead. this deal we're doing for Buck and Hunger this year, this will be my fourth year there. Won it twice. Thanks, you're ready to win it again this year. But there's going to be a lot of competition this year, too. And, you know, there's going to be four of the guys in there, and they're going to be fighting. They're going to be digging and clawing. But, I don't really have to worry about them. It's, just me and the bull. All I got to do is beat him and stay in control. And the same to the guys that are fighting against me. And just let the pencils fall, see where they rest.
And see where they go. That's a good deal. And it was a great show last year. The folks can catch, if you go to the Pepper Stewart TV YouTube, we got the video from last year's bullfights on there. You can check that out. And then, of course, we'll shoot them again this year and load them up on there. And I guess what we'll do, we'll throw out a little tune for you guys, and then we will come back with some more stuff. And Jesse's got some other stuff going on, too, in the works that we're going to tell you about. And then we've got, as always, plenty of random stories. Because everybody likes the random stories. So we'll throw a tune at you. We'll come back here shortly and talk about stuff.
This is a song about a retired bucking bull. I can smell you from the tree there. I'm the bull they call Brangus Bob.
Yep.
I saw you winking and I heard you tinkling. That all got me to thinking. Loving you is my job. And I love you with all my horns. And I want you. Do you know I care?
I really do.
You say it's time. I say I'm ready. Can I call you Betty? They picked me up at the sale barn with just a few waves of an arm. Then someone hot shot at my ass. I was sprayed and I was wormed. Vaccinated for all kinds of germs. Brought out here and put on grass. And I love you with all my horns. And I want you to know I care.
I really do.
You say it's time. I say I'm ready. Nice to meet you, Betty. The bridge has been censored, but those who understand this don't need any kind of visual aid. I even turned my head so they could have their moment, but I swear I overheard Bob say, that sure beats the bucking sheets, or turning into cowboy boots. I believe you will see me again. But for now, I must go. I've got a date with a Simmental. She's a heifer standing somewhere upwind.
All right, that's the Well-Feds right there. The Well-Feds. That's also who does our show intro right there. The Well-Feds. Check them out, thewellfeds.com. Matter of fact, they will be here at Love and War for a songwriters event. I think next month or so. Check them out. And also, if you got any questions, you want to ask something, you see everybody sitting around in here, and you get questionable. You want to ask a question? Shoot it on over. Chat it up on the chatter box right there, and we'll answer for you. We'll tell you some stuff. Let's jump on the cattle report right quick. Everybody wants to know about the cattle report because they were blowing up me up because I didn't do the weekly farm rest report this week just for the fact we were getting resituated. Let me throw this out there for you right quick. If you can look at the process here, this is in Emory. As you can tell, they're continuing to go down. You are looking at. All right, let's not do that.
I did go to the rodeo this weekend.
Tex went to the rodeo. What did you do at the rodeo, Tex?
I took pictures, did a studio, talked to people.
All right.
Yeah.
That's what you did. We'll dive in that more here. Let's jump on these cattle prices right quick. How about that? Here we go. Right here in Emory, Texas, you're looking at the Emory Livestock Report. They're down again. We're below a dollar here. We're at about 70 cents. Everything's kicking off about 70 to 75 cents, 80 cents. Your packing cows are 30 cents to 68 cents. Heavy bulls, 60 to 82. Your top pairs were 1,000 to 1,400, and your low to middle pairs was 750 to 1,000. And then your stocking cows was 65 cents to $1.20. Baby calves, $15 to $3.25. Horses, $50 to $5.50. And your goats and sheep are $25 to $160 out there in Emory, Texas. So cattle prices continue to drop every week. So what'd you do, Tex? You went to Mesquite Rodeo. What happened?
What did happen? I don't remember what going on during the rodeo, but after the rodeo, they had a live band after party.
That's all you know about, or what?
That's all I remember.
What happened at the after party?
maybe I checked that wrong.
who showed up? You had Liz there or Marlena?
I had a dancing partner there. It's just say that.
All right.
I always let the cat out of the bag. Maybe I need to shut up or not. I remember I just can't tell people I stayed at home.
That's probably a better idea. You won't get your tires cut that way. Who'd you take with you?
Eddie Stilson.
Yeah, that guy.
All right. So what else happened?
I took a long fan, a long time fan. You should hear that. I took a fan of the show, fan of the rodeo, a fan of Tex Stewart. That's all it was. Yeah.
All right. Now, look, if you didn't know, now you do or you missed it. But the ERA, we did the ERA broadcast out there for. We hit it up about every other week during the qualifiers, and we were there for the semifinals doing that. And it turned out pretty good. Some of the guys that you wouldn't think of made it, and you had the kids get it. You had the 16-year-old Cannon Cravens that won the bull riding out there. So that turned out to be a pretty good event. Of course, Tex had I'd be busy, I guess. As always. What story are you trying to tell me? You trying to tell me you're getting rich? You've been trying to tell me all day that you're going to be rich and you're moving to Mexico or something. What?
I know I'm moving to the Ukraine.
All right. Huh? What happened to Ukraine?
She's funny.
What'd you get? What happened?
I don't know where you got this article, but apparently somebody will want to. What? Will you mind finding a young, nice girl? My name is Yule. I'm from the Ukraine.
All right.
Have you ever heard that the loveliest girls in the world live in my country? Don't even doubt. Go to my account here.
Go to her account?
I have more pictures for you to show you. Talk soon.
All right. So what are you going to do with that?
I may want to pick. I don't know. Somebody want to give me $5 million in my 2015 Yahoo email.
What?
Well, no thanks.
I got to just click on the link and give them my account number.
Well, you're the expert.
What happened? What'd you do?
And then somebody else wanted to give me $2.5 million.
So you're rich now.
Yeah.
How do you get that money?
All you got to do is go to a Western Union. You know, put some kind of digi in, put your digi on your account number, give it your name, address, and they direct deposit it into your account. Get that easy.
Alright.
And then I take that money and move to Ukraine.
What are you going to do?
And find Jewel.
Well, which Jewel's that? The singer? That's the singer? Or what are you talking about?
I don't know. If you're going to give me pictures, you gotta let you know. I'll let you know next week what you look like.
He might end up on catfish. Catfish in about a year.
Long as I don't end up on
First 48?
No, yeah, First 40.
I know you want to help, but this is getting out of control.
Oh, man. All right.
Well, I'll catch your predator. That's what I'm finding. As long as I don't end up on catch your predator.
Yeah, that's the one you don't want to be on. You don't want to be on that one for sure.
I got to make sure you're old enough, folks. Right?
That's right. You'll be in trouble quick. The ERA, we're talking about the ERA, finishing up. They're in Mesquite. The 14-week qualifier series had 16 of the guys that qualified to make it over to downtown Dallas to the finals. And in the bull riding, you had Cannon Craven the Friday Wright. Your barrel racers were Shirley Morgan and Jennifer Kalifatik. What? I don't know what they say that, but I'm close enough. Your saddle bronc, Ty Kirkland and Mike Outer. Tie down was Cooper Martin and Ty Pride. Your bareback riders, Justin Miller and Jesse Anderson. Team roping, you had Casey Hicks and Braden Harmon, Matt Sherwood and Wesley Thorpe. And then the steer wrestling was Chris Berry and Cash Myers going downtown.
And what are the dates on the finals?
The finals are going to be the 11th through the 13th. But then they opened it up for the 9th and 10th for those guys that for some reason missed out. They've been having this for a long time. But if you've been living under a rock, you missed out. They're giving you another opportunity to qualify on the 9th and 10th. So on the October the 10th, open the books up, and you can get entered up at Fair Park for the 9th and 10th at Fair Park, and they're going to take the top two there over to Dallas as well.
So how many are they having for
a bit? That's going to be about 15, I guess. Probably about 15, what they're looking at. That's what I would think. I think about 15.
What?
Let's see if we can run this out. We got this reel here of the little highlight reel of the qualifiers. We'll throw it out there right quick. And
Texas A&M, come on.
Enjoy that little It's a bit of rodeo right there. That's from the last 2 days semifinals there at Mesquite for the ERA qualifier. A lot of those folks qualified to be in Dallas, so that's where you'll see them next. So what do you got? What do you got going over, Jesse? You got something?
Oh, yeah, we want to, you know, we're talking about, you know, giving back to the community with this open, you know, with the food bank and everything. And, you know, and I think it's pretty cool that we got, you know, the same community of bulls coming. We got Jimmy Fricks and, you know, Chris Knapp bringing bulls and also the fighting bulls. And, you know, that's a really cool thing, I think, for the people to come in and watch the deal, that those bulls that are coming that are, you know, really good bucking bulls, really good fighting bulls are coming from right here where they're at. They're not coming from another state or anything like that. But these bulls are raised right here in their backyard. And I think that ought to be something more for the people to watch, you know,
yeah,
to see how they buck, you know, because they watch TV, they see the PBR, Mesquite, you know, all them things. So people live in Mesquite, they see bulls in Mesquite, and they know they come from right around here. And so they see, you know, we got good bulls here, you know, because most of the stuff you see on the PBR is from way out of state.
Yeah.
Other side of the United States, you know. But these kind of bulls that we're going to have and fighting bulls are raised right here in your backyard. And, you know, we're going to, and I think that's a great thing for everybody to see. And we're going to open with bull riding. We're going to start with bull riding. And then we go to the Pony Bronx. And I'm going to tell you, them kids ain't got no quit at all. And there it is. That is something to watch there. And, you know, them kids, you see them and they're, you know, 9, 10, 11, 12 years old, and, you know, and they're getting whooped around and stuff like that. It's kind of like you say, you can't whoop your kid in Walmart, but you can put him on a bronc, let him get beat up.
There you go.
Yeah. So it's really cool watching. You can see what kids are raised up in the country and riding, you know, bucking horses and, you know, raised on ranches and stuff. That's a really good event to show in Cleveland. That's a really good event. And, you know, we're going to go back with bulls again. And then, you know, and then we're going to do the wild steer race. And that is, that is chaos. I'm telling you. Oh, no. Glenn's in it. Yeah, so that wild steer race is something to watch. Yeah, so everybody just kind of take their bets and see who gets hurt first.
Yeah.
So, and then we'll end with bulls again, then we'll go to the bullfights. And we'll put on, everybody I know is going to be there is going to put on a good show. And anything that, but I guarantee you, the louder the crowd, the better we're going to fight, and better the bulls are going to fight, and better the bulls are going to buck. So, you know, usually most of us like working with crowds, and we'll get y'all pumped up, and we'll put on a good show.
And it's going to be good stuff. And we've got, you don't want to forget, we've got Avid Video Rodeo Imagery out there taking pictures, shooting shots. You see their shots featured all over PRCA, PBR. They've been on the cover of Humps and Horns magazine. They're going to be out there shooting this event. So if you're going to want to, you know, if you're out there and you're entering up and, you know, everybody wants a picture, you know, everybody's got a picture. You know, cause when you get old like me, you got like five pictures, everybody's like, where's your pictures at? Well, now's your chance to come out there and get a great shot by these guys that are going to be out there shooting this event. So you want to be out there and get on some. Put your grandma on one, too. Why not? She might want to ride one. Yeah, we got Tex. Tex is set up in a bullfighting jersey.
Put a little exhibition fight on.
Yeah. I may have to get in on.
Put a little steer in there.
Yeah. We're going to bring a little hook and heifer out there.
Maybe a baby calf. I did a baby calf.
You what?
A calf.
You're going to tell the folks what not to do? Yeah. How you do that.
Yeah.
I'll show you.
I don't show folks how to vote to the fence.
We're gonna time to see how fast you get to the fence.
Well, yeah.
See which bar you hit. Which is the first bar you hit going up.
I bet he trips on the way through.
Yeah.
I maybe get him a huddle over the fence. I don't know.
Oh man, it's gonna be a good show. It's gonna be a good event. If you're in the area, you need to come out. I mean, what else you got to do on a Saturday night? Besides come watch some good bull riding, bull fighting. Pony Bronx, they got a concert going on.
Yeah,
there's a concert that starts at 6 o'clock. Actually, our mutton busting is going to kick off at 4:30. And then we have a concert starting at 6. A great band called the Ledbetters. I mean, they are good. But the deal about this is, yes, it all goes to the food bank,
But it's hard to go somewhere in this area. It's $12 for adults. We don't try to make the ticket prices too high when you can't bring your family. But it is hard, not bragging or anything, but for $12 to go see this caliber of show, it's not going to happen.
And you're close. I mean, you're not sitting up in the nosebleed. You're not. I mean, you're right there in the action.
Not at all. You know, and we cut the arena off. You know, it's a half pin, so you know it keeps the action going. You know, it makes it for Jason and him ain't having to chase these things in the down pin. Yeah, and it's $12 for adults. Children 6 through 12 is $5 at the gate, and $5 for adults. So, yeah, there's T-shirts, there's vendors. Food, all kinds of food, good food. It's a big deal. And plus, this year we're adding a shark tank.
The shark tank.
There's going to be a shark tank.
They're making deals in the arena.
Yeah, $5. $5 a raffle ticket. There'll be 12 names drawing.
That's where you want to go because, you know, if you saw some of the videos that we've been posting from at Mesquite, we shot those from the shark cage.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're going to give the fans an opportunity.
So you want to be in that
right
thing.
In the middle of the action.
You up close and personal. Now we are getting some feedback on the chatterbox over there. I think they've decided that Tex needs to fight a sheep.
Oh, yeah. A sheep. Can you run fast enough to chase a sheep?
Yeah. The sheep may chase me. I don't want to be chasing the sheep.
You did that already, didn't you?
I'm gonna stay away from that.
Oh man, well, it's gonna be a good show. It's gonna be good stuff. A lot of things going on out there. And what we're gonna do? We're gonna throw another tune. In your ear holes. We're going to come back and talk about some more stuff.
She likes the Beatles, and I like the Stones. She likes romantic movies. I like Indiana Jones, yeah. She goes to church, and I stay at home. Oh, she likes the Beatles, and I like the Stones. We met on the river. In the mid-morning light, she swears it was late afternoon. She fell in love by the time it was night. I didn't get until June. Not long after we said I do, she had the nerve to move in. She painted the walls, she pinned up my dog, and she kicked out all. She brings me coffee, I'm working late. She lifts me up when I'm low. She understands when I'm carrying weight that I just have to hold up alone. She's determined and honest, she's stubborn and strong. And I always know where she stands. So it never bugs me, she's always wrong. As long as she's around.
Another good tune. They just don't end sometimes. I don't know. Like they fell down or something. All right, we're back again. You are tuned in once more to the Pepper Stewart Show. And you got the Wild Bill Tex Travis over there. He's awake, not sleeping.
You got, I think I'm awake.
You got world champion bullfighter Jesse Vick right there in the middle. And rounding out the other side, you got Glen Cooper. He's awake. He's not asleep. He just looks like it. I think everybody's battling the cold right now. I think everybody, or I don't know if it's a cold or just an allergy infestation. Yeah.
That's what we're
That's what it is.
It's just getting after everybody. But I guess we'll dive off into the randomness of the randomness here. So what do we got? You got a story over there you can talk about, Tex? You tell me what you're going to do, and I'll throw it out there.
We mentioned Taco Bell.
Taco what?
Taco Bell. Taco Bell has a special night to offer you.
All right. What about that?
In Canada.
Them Canadians are funny about stuff.
A one contest winner and the three fans will have the opportunity to stay in a Taco Bell location. Yeah. For the new release. I guess they're releasing a new steak, Double Dilla.
They're making new tacos or what? Yeah. Taco's been around a while.
I guess they got real steak in it. Are they going to call it steak?
They'll call it steak. It's just called steak.
But you can stay. You can stay tonight.
So the Taco
and
Bell.
Then I guess you can stay tonight and then eat the steak still.
Well, they got it fancy in there. It's fancy. It's part of the Taco Bell's Canadian Steakcation. Instead of a staycation, you got a steakcation contest there. So this Taco Bell location in Chatham, Ontario, will be outfitted with two sets of bunk beds, some comfy chairs, and a big screen TV. The Airbnb listing states. So in addition to the feast of steak double dillas, the listing promises video games, movies, and Taco Bell butler to cater to the guest.
I don't think I had it.
Not Taco Bell butler. Don't look like somebody I want him to help me.
Now, the contestants can enter via the Airbnb listing, and the winning group will spend the night October 17th. So that's coming up. I'm waiting on the follow-up on this deal. That's what I want. I want to see the follow-up.
Taco Bell is usually open late. Now, is Taco Bell going to be open while they're spending the night, or are they going to be closed?
I don't know. We need more to the store. We need to know more about that. I need to know a little bit more. What about this alligator? You know anything about alligators?
Well, we got an alligator. We got an alligator in Australia.
They say everything over will kill you.
Well, if anybody, there's a crocodile.
Crocodile. Yeah, you know how you tell the difference in a crocodile and alligator? One will see you later, and the other will see you after a while.
Yeah.
I guess. Yeah.
But they caught him.
All right.
Tied him down. Hauled off on a trailer. But are they blaming the crocodile or the cow for getting too close? Which one is it?
I don't know.
Could be a little bit of both.
Well, I thought those were what the crocodiles and alligators did in Australia.
Had a battle.
I've seen Crocodile Dundee too many times.
That cow needs a bigger knife.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
So they had there's video of this. I guess I should have pulled the video so I could show the video. But they wrangled. They didn't just catch him. They wrangled this 14-foot crocodile.
Well, they want to get on QPR or what?
On the what?
I don't know. Maybe you got him.
He didn't want to get bit.
Oh, okay.
So he's gonna. They're gonna use two rolls of duct tape on that one. So they captured this, they called it an unorthodox distraction.
He went rogue.
Unorthodox.
He went crazy again.
But they said there's a bigger one. They're saying there's reports of a bigger crocodile out there.
14 foot long. I don't know how I want to keep one.
You ever watch that swamp, that show Swamp?
Swamp people?
Swamp People? Where they go up there and catch them alligators and shoot them with a .22.
Yeah, I don't know how we do that.
I'm taking more than 22 if I'm going hunting alligators like they do.
I watched one where they shot the alligator and the thing, they took off in the boat and the thing, it wasn't dead.
Oh, yeah?
Back alive, yeah. That was entertaining.
You don't want to do that.
I think I'd have been jumping out of that boat. He could have my boat. See you later.
See you later, alligator. I must have been alligator because they saw you later. What about, you know anything about the, you ever thought about anything about Norwegian? The Norwegian,
I don't know,
people?
Apparently Norwegian Prime Minister playing Pokemon.
What?
Yeah. I ain't never played that Pokemon Go, but apparently
you play,
I didn't play it out.
You don't play Pokemon?
No, I
know. You sure?
I only do, I go,
yeah. Uh-huh. All right. Well, this, the Norwegian Prime Minister was caught in the act of trying to catch them all. A news photographer captured her playing Pokemon Go on Tuesday while listening to a heated debate at the Norway's parliament. I guess it was an interesting debate because she's played Pokemon. Back in August, she even took some time off from the state visit and to hunt Pokemon on the streets of Brastalov, according to the news. Now, her decision to play Pokemon Go during the debate might have been rude, but it seems the game's popularity crosses some Norwegian political lines. The leaders of Norway's Conservative Party and the person speaking during her Pokemon Go session was none other than some other name I can't say. The leader of Norway's Liberal Party. She was caught on camera playing Pokemon, or the Liberal Party was Grande. She was caught on camera playing Pokemon Go herself in August in a meeting of Norwegian Parliament Foreign Affairs and Defense. She just finished asking questions and then switched to the app. When the reporters asked her about that, she said, some people have heads that listen better when doing something brain dead.
Whatever that means.
I don't know, but they reached out to they reached out to Pikachu, and he was unable to comment. What else you got? You got some stuff floating around over there?
We got a hurricane break in the East Coast.
Hurricane what?
Hurricane, I don't know the name. I don't remember the hurricane. But it took out a hurricane break in the East Coast. So we got what to do before, during, and after the storm.
And that goes with anything. That goes with, it goes, you know, whether it's a hurricane, a tornado, or a storm, whatever. It just goes back to what we tell you all the time, to make sure that all your livestock's branded. Make sure your cows are branded. Make sure your horses are branded. Your goats, you can brand your goats. Some people brand their dogs.
You can you can microchip your pet.
But microchip ain't going to help you. You can microchip your dog, and that's all, that's good if whoever catches it decides to do
good
some TSA, you know, do a TSA wand across it and find a microchip. But with things going on, whether no matter where you're at, you've got to make sure that that your stock is identifiable. Because we got caught years ago in Rita. I guess it was Rita down in Houston. We were down in Houston. And we had to move a bunch of cows out, a bunch of horses out, stuff like that. Well, if they're not branded or tagged or some form of identification, then you just got to wonder, when you get all these cows together, how are you going to know whose cows are who? And then you got to worry about your neighbor, which he's going to take as many cows as he can.
Be the honest buddy system.
Yeah. The honest.
What do they do with the ones that, I mean, nobody claims? I mean, where do they go?
They just run them, a lot. If nobody claims them, I guess they'll sell them. Yeah. But I'm sure somebody will claim them. But that's what they tell you to do. And I see a lot of folks don't like to brand their horses or whatever, and they tell them, you know, in a storm situation like that, either spray paint them or take a permanent marker right on their hooves. Write your phone number on them somewhere.
They got them brand inspectors at the sale barns, and they're supposed to check all them brands, but you got to report your brand to the sale barns, and then they'll find out if, you know, they won't run them through the sale and sell them because they know that brand's been missing or whatever. So
yeah.
That brand makes a big difference, huge difference. Saves a lot of money.
Yeah, because I've talked to the guy there in Emory that does the brand inspection. He sits out there, and he writes every tag and every brand. Whatever comes through, he sits there and checks everything that comes through just for that fact. And like we do here, a lot of times we'll do the stolen cattle news from the Texas Cattle Raiser Report, and we'll have we had one a couple weeks ago of a trailer or something that got stolen that we talked about got stolen, and then later on it got found. And it's the same thing with everything else. That if you're not branding your cows, branding your stock, whatever, you're just making that much more difficult on yourself. Harder to find it. What'd you brand? You look like you're thinking hard over there. I see smoke coming out of your ears. Last time you said about branding your wife.
Yeah, I was just thinking about my line. You brand everything. Cow, horses, women, dogs, all that. Fortunately, that doesn't change, can it?
She's my wife.
You're going to brand them all, huh?
Kind of
like Pokemon. You caught them all, didn't you? You know they got horses in Philadelphia?
Horses in Philadelphia.
They got horses in Philadelphia.
Yeah, the Philadelphia horse in the mud.
In the what?
In the mud. Mud. A rescue crew in Philadelphia worked to lift the horse to freedom after it became stuck in a mud pit for hours.
Yeah. See, the owner of the horse told CBS in Philadelphia the horse was walking near the water when it became stuck, began to panic, and ultimately dug itself deeper in the mud.
80% of the horse was submerged. What does that look like? Only the horse's head was digging out of the mud? Or
yeah, just 80%. About. There ain't much. There's not much sticking out now. You can see right there in that.
Oh, we got a picture of it.
Yeah, he's stuck. It's an 18-year-old. 18-year-old horse.
1,700-pound horse, pretty big.
Tranquilized. They just make it harder on themselves to rescue that horse if they tranquilize them. At least if you don't tranquilize him, he can help himself a little bit, kind of help you out. But they tranquilize him and use chains and sling to stabilize him. And about 24 rescuers appeared on the scene and was eventually removed from the hole.
No wound or injury.
Looks like in a swamp. I didn't think they had swamp in Philadelphia. That looks like a swamp hole.
Maybe. I don't know.
Is that quicksand?
Yeah, quicksand. I guess, I don't know.
They've been watching a never-ending story? that's some old stuff. You did your mailbag already, didn't you?
Yeah. Did we do the British man and vinyl record yet? I know we mentioned it.
What about your British man with a vinyl record? What do? You play your song?
In England. This is an England story.
All right.
British man uncovered a novel use for the company's new plastic 5-pound bill, playing a vinyl record.
A vinyl record?
Vinyl record.
What? A vinyl? What are you talking about?
That's a new one. That's a new one that you made up.
You making stuff up with it. So this record plays jumbled sound, before the bill is properly positioned. And then once it's positioned, it plays
Money, Money, Money.
ABBA? What?
The two Money, Money, Money.
I want to know where this plastic bill is at, because I was just there in June. I didn't have any plastic money.
The microchip?
What a $5.
It's $5.
Or 5 pounds, I guess. I guess that's what they call it over
there. Yeah, five pounds. That
the
was
vibration
right. It says, the vibration said it'll play that.
And play the call Money, Money, Money.
And for a $5 bill, we'll play AC/DC or something like that. I might play something sad when it's going down.
Oh, man. Yeah, I didn't see any rubber bills like that when I was over there. Of course, I like to go in there. See, when we go over there, it's there summertime, but for me, it's wintertime. Because it's 60 degrees over there. In June, it's 65 degrees. So I'm wearing a coat everywhere. People walk wearing shorts.
Really?
They're like, oh, you're cold? Yeah, it's
and
cold.
It's summertime over there?
Yeah, it's summertime over there.
Well, it's winter.
In winter, it's cold. It's freezing over there.
Really?
It's snow and ice and 20 below and stuff like that. Cold.
What time of the year is that? The game time? Christmas time? Or
yeah, I think so. What?
I saw text, I'm not commenting. That is a good question, though, Jesse. Is there any, like, superstition, anything you eat or drink before?
I usually eat the same thing. A lot of people don't, and they don't care, but since I was little playing football, I'd get sick if I ate before a football game, and since I fought bulls, I don't know, it was just something in my head. I don't eat right before the rodeo. I just think I'm going to get sick. Not that I have, but I just think I'll get sick. So But usually I eat the same, pretty much the same thing every day before the rodeo, and it's always kept me pretty safe, I reckon. And, like wearing the same makeup, same socks. You know, we're going to wear jerseys this year at the Buck and Hunger. You know, same fighting hat. But makeup's usually a superstition that I like keeping with.
Put it on the same way every time.
And that, you know, and there's a lot of people that don't even know what I look like without makeup. Because that's the only time they get to see me is with makeup on. But yeah, I can walk right by a bull rider and, you know, say hi to him. Won't say nothing to me. Just keep on going. And, you know, bull riding starts, and it's 10 minutes before, and I'll be makeup, you know, ready to go and get in the alley. And, oh, man, I'm so glad you're here. I'm like, man, I just saw you 20 minutes ago.
Yeah.
It ain't even – but, yeah, I wear a lot of makeup, more than most. But it's, you know, just a signature for me. And if I'm wearing a different shirt or shorts or anything like that, you can see my makeup, my hat, you'll know it's me.
And that's something that's lost today in the bullfighting world. Everybody wants jerseys and shorts and no makeup and all that, but you know, in the old times that's how you recognize people. That's how you know who was who. You know, when you seen the guys, you know, that wore the same design shirt and everything, every time you knew who it was. But now you see these guys in jerseys and no makeup, and it's like, well, oh, there's just another guy walking around over there.
Yeah, you get pictures with the kids and stuff, and most of the kids that come up, they want a picture with the clowns. I mean, that's what they go there. You know, if they're going to tell their mom and dad, hey, you want to go take a picture with the bullfighter, usually they're going to say, I want to take a picture with the clowns.
Yep.
And, you know, if you've got a lot of makeup on and stuff, it's going to make that, you know, that picture with that kid last forever. But if you just got a regular jersey on and, you know, no makeup, especially for small towns like this,
yeah,
you know, it's not really going to, you know, sink the home with them kids like we, you know, like it would with makeup on. So, yeah, I think, you know, I've always been told, things you don't do with makeup by certain people and things you do with makeup. So I just kind of molded that around and made my own signature.
Yeah,
makeup and stayed with it, and every single time I step in the ring, I keep the same thing.
And that's what you got to do. That's how they reckon. I mean, I wore the same colors and the same design every show, no matter what it was. I had the same design every time, and people, that's how they recognize you. That's how they know who you are. They'll see, oh, that's so and so. I saw them here. I saw them there. Whatever. But then when you got everybody looks alike, who's that? You see it all the time on the Facebook and everything else. You see, and you know, I got that bullfighting group and everything. You see it's mostly the kids, and they get in there. Hey, where can I get that Dickie's jersey? I need a Dickie's jersey. I need some Dickie shorts. No, you don't. Be yourself. Create your own identity.
Right. I usually, until now, times change. And, you know, things change with that. But typically, I usually wear a blue and white striped shirt. And if anybody usually has a blue and white striped shirt and they see a picture of it and my back's to the picture or whatever, they know who it is.
Yeah, it's going to be you because you're the only one that wears it. Yeah.
But, you know, the only thing I can keep before wearing jerseys is my makeup, my socks, things that they're going to be able to notice, you know, or even question. And, you know, that's really all we can do. But like I say, times have changed.
Yeah, and it's different now. I mean, you've got a lot of different producers and things that put on events, and they'll get they'll want you to wear the jerseys because they're advertising jerseys. So I mean, yeah, it's another deal if you're getting, you know, you're getting paid to wear the jersey. Hey, that's all part of it, and you wear it. But when you're out doing your own thing or doing your bullfights or whatever, and it's a different deal. Then a lot of these guys need to pick an identity, what they want to go with, and that'll be your signature right there. There's no question about that. Just like my old neighbor when I was a kid growing up, that got me into all the bullfights. When you seen yellow and black, you knew exactly who that was. There was no question who the bumblebee was when you seen yellow and black. And same thing with Miles Hare. Miles Hare was that way. You could pick
red
him out of anything.
Yeah, red and white.
Yep. You knew exactly who you were looking at.
And we did a, you know, after Rick had passed away, we did a deal down in Jasper, Texas. And he was from around there, And we're going to do a big tribute to him.
Yeah.
Well, come to find out, of course, and he fought that rodeo many years, many, many years. Him and Myers also. Miles did too. And they fought that for many years. Well, we're going to do, and my makeup is similar, but it's not the same.
Yeah.
His is yellow, and it's sharp points and things like that, but it's similar. And so I thought, well, I said, well, when we do that tribute on Saturday night, I said, I'll get my yellow makeup, and I'll, if I could find a shirt like it. Well, come to find out, one of the committee members that's lived there his whole life, grew up there, he was one of the kids when Rick was fighting there. He had a shirt that Rick Chapman gave him.
Huh.
It was still in the bag and starched and ready to go.
Yeah.
And so he came to me, and I've been fighting it for many years, and he come to me and said, you going to do that deal for Rick? And I said, yeah, I'm going to do it for Rick. I said, I've met Rick here in Jasper, and I said, I'd love to do a tribute to him, whatever we're going to do. And he said, well, I've got a shirt. I said, you're kidding. He said, I want you to wear it. I said, I'd love to.
Yeah.
And he brought it to me. You should have seen all the stitching in that shirt for one of his fighting shirts from the NFR
yeah.
and all the Ring of the Bullfight. Oh, my God. It looked like Frankenstein's put that thing together. Yeah. But it was starched into plastic and everything, and it was a really good deal. I got some stuff on my Facebook, some pictures of me throwing a fake at a bull there in Jasper, and it was a really, really cool deal. And at the end of that rodeo, Todd McDonald is the one. He told me after the end of it, he told me, I want you to have it. And I got it hanging up in my closet.
That's something you want to hang on to right there.
Yep.
Yeah.
Still got it.
That is something to hang on to. Cause he did a lot of stuff for a lot of folks.
Yeah. He's overcome a lot of injuries that people couldn't overcome.
Yeah.
And stories that he's told me, and people don't really know about is he fought bulls with half his toes, the end of his career, and it was crazy how it happened. But that's a different story. But that was crazy. He had to learn how to walk again and a lot of different things.
Now, was that part of the skiing trip or that was something else? Yeah. That was a skiing trip, yeah.
He was stranded for many, many days, ended up getting frostbite.
Yeah, he got frostbite.
He'd take his toes off, and then but he never stopped. He got back in it, and he kept on trucking. And, for somebody to have to learn how to run, walk again, let alone run again.
Yeah.
That was something huge. That's a heart right there.
That's overcoming. That's overcoming right there.
Yeah, that's crazy. Yeah, he was a good guy, man. And, you see him fight bulls and you never met him before. You think, he's so aggressive fighting bulls. He was just phenomenal to watch.
Yeah.
But you meet him, he was such a nice guy.
Mm-hmm.
He was so nice. He was just a super guy and a world champ. He was just a super guy. It was an honor for me to meet him before he had passed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. What are you doing, Tex? You sleeping over there?
I'm awake.
Did you know William Shatner rides horses?
No, I did not.
You did not know that?
I did not know that.
We got a couple minutes here before we kill it. But, yeah, William Shatner.
Where can I find him at? Where can I find him on a horse?
Where can you find him on a horse?
Yeah.
He's right there on a horse. All right. He's 86 years old, and he's still riding and competing at the Las Vegas High Roller Reining Classic. So he's 86 years old out there reining horses.
You want to go to Vegas or
what? I'm ready to go to Vegas. What happened in Vegas? Stay in Vegas. You're listening.
Yeah.
Might be what happened in Texas. Are we still in Vegas?
Yeah. Yeah, he's been there a long time.
I've been talking to my little California girlfriend.
Your what?
My California fan.
Four different women.
Yeah. This guy. Oh, man.
Digging a hole.
Old Tex right there.
California.
Old Tex. He's always into something. That's right. That's what we're doing. You guys come out to the Buck and Hunger event, October 15th. Check it out. And see what's going on. It's on the Facebook page, Pepper Stewart Show. Go check it out. Look it up. See what's going on. Check out Tex Travis. He's on Facebook, Tex Travis. Buck and Hunger. There's a page for Buck and Hunger as well as the Open Door Food Bank. Check it out. Come out there and see what's going on. And until then, we'll see you guys on to the next one.